Everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. It's time for another Cranky Show. Another Cranky Show. Remember the big bundle of parts, the lineup of parts. They are slowly reducing because we are getting things together here. Actually, nothing is glued. I'm just having a little bit of fun with this as I paint, mocking it up. As you can see here, you're not going to be able to see it with the naked eye, but we've got this, maybe you could see it a little bit better there. I used a variety of colors and mostly, rust underneath and then a bunch of different blacks that gave me this kind of faded and grungy. I mean, it's a smooth surface. There's no real texture here, but it just gave me this grungy black that I wanted, because again, I wanted the contrast between the black and the red. Speaking of red, we got the wheels painted really, really bright red, and then we applied a wash. And the art of the wash is, I mean, there's nothing simpler. It's one of the earlier techniques that you learn. You know, this is an acrylic wash, and you can control the wash a little bit. You know, I usually like to flood the part and then come back with a Q-tip or a moist paper towel, kind of turned into a tip, rolled up into a tip, and then wipe the excess after it's dried a little bit. So I'm very pleased with the wheels. I think the wheels are going to really, really stand out. I've already sanded them. They're getting a little bit weathered once the model is finally assembled and ready. I'll come back in and do a little bit more weathering with the airbrush. This is a painstaking, time-consuming work, but it's worth it if you're going to do it right. Now, when I pick up this model, a lot of things are going to start moving because, again, nothing is glued, but there it is. There's really no way to do checkerboard, at this scale. With tape or anything, because it falls apart when you cut it. So this is a template for carbon fiber that I have for recreating carbon fiber. And of course, whoever is working on this rat rod, decided to have a different door panel there, and then redid the graphic. Remember, embrace your mistakes, my friends. Embrace your mistakes. What happened here originally was I didn't line up the template correctly, and it came out all messed up. So I came back in, and again, you learn after a while that when you're working on rusty and gunky, you can save your model, and not get frustrated. So I just masked it, put some gray primer, and then reshot the decal on there. And it just gives it already a lot of interest and a lot of variety. The chassis, the trunk, it's got, a toothpick holding it up. But the tank is going to go in there, maybe some magazines and stuff. The interior of this kit, by the way, if I can warn you now, the interior of this kit, you do not want to glue it outside of a body. You need to fit it inside. Okay, the seats are loose. Let me remove them. The seats are loose, and that's fine, okay, because, they go in last, and so does the, the dashboard. But this kit, the beauty of this kit, look at the fit on that thing. It's all snapped in there, okay, in place. That's the only way you're going to be able to get it in. If it's loose, you begin with the rear, and then you add the sides, and then, the dashboard and the seats. So do not work on the interior outside of the body and then think that you're going to squeeze it in, because these things are in there, And so, you know, and I like to glue those things in place first. So anyway, this is just paint, by the way. There's no weathering of any sort done here. This chassis this frame is just one of my favorites right now. I love the way it looks. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to modernize some of the axle, the rear axle, the front, and make it look maybe like it's a work in progress that they're fixing up. Look at that mesh. I got a nice scale mesh on there. So this thing is just coming along, and I'm loving every minute of it. Again, it's a good kit. I think it's going to build up well, and it's going to look, you know, it's going to look super cool once it's got all the right stuff on it. And as I said, there's no weathering yet other than paint. The interior, of course, has got that wash too, you know, so the interior is pretty much done. I just have to detail it, put the seats in and stuff like that. But this kit is fitting really, really nice. And that's, I didn't do anything to it. That's the way it comes out of the box. So I have all these parts to airbrush. And so the fun is still ahead. But by this weekend, I hope to have it in final assembly and get going on some detailing and stuff. So anyway, my friends, stay tuned in. More Cranky Show coming right up. All right.